It's me, Periwinkle. Blue and I are playing school, so I can figure out what school is all about. Will you play with us? Perry, perfect! It'll be great having a friend like you in my class today. And since we're in the same class, tell Blue and me all about you. You can use these letters to write your name. And here you can tell me how old you are, and when your birthday is, and which one of these pictures looks like you.
Hey everyone, welcome back to another episode of Lilbumblebear's Let's Play. I'm Kristen Lilbumblebear, and I'm back with Blue's Clues. This is Blue's Kindergarten. I hope you all enjoy. Be sure to give this video a thumbs up if you do. Leave a comment down below telling me if you remember Blue's Clues, if you played this game, and subscribe for more nostalgic gaming. Check out the playlist in the description box for other Blue's Clues games I've done on this channel. I'm so glad that you're here. Thank you for watching. Please enjoy. Oh, last thing. I do stream on Twitch. Feel free to follow my channel, twitch.tv/lilbumblebear. I have a Twitter and an Instagram you can follow me on. And I have a Discord server for all of you. If you'd like to be in my server, let me know in the comments down below and I'll get you an invite. Okay, let's begin.
K-R-I-S-T-E-N, girl. Girl, cool, Blue's a girl too. This is where you. Now that I know all about you, tell me all the things you like. What do you see here that you like best? Let's a triceratops. A spider. An elephant. A pretzel. Aquamarine.
Oh, hi. Periwinkle Blue and I were just talking about school. Do you go to school? Oh, really?
You know what? I'm going to school. Really, Blue? You love school? Well, it makes me kind of nervous.
Nervous? Blue. What do you do at school? Cool book, Blue.
You get to do all those things? Well, I love to read and count and say the alphabet and draw and do science. That does sound great, but I'm still a little nervous.
Well, what else can we do so that Periwinkle will feel better about going to school? We can play school right here? Right here at home?
Perry, perfect! Let's play school here so I can see what it's like. Will you play school with us?
You'll play? Great. You know, Periwinkle is lucky to have such great friends.
Joe, come see if you can find me.
Oh, right. Tickety and I were playing hide and seek. I'm coming, Tickety. Come and find me later, okay? Ready or not, here I come.
To school we go.
Thank you.
looks like there are a lot of things to do in school. What do you think we should do first? Should we play rhyme time with Mr. Salt and Mrs. Pepper? Practice telling time with Tickety? Make a book all about us? Learn about math out on the sand table? Or should we learn about super science in my fort? Every time you complete a school activity with me and Blue, you get a Perry Perfect project page to play with. You can keep your project pages here in this folder. Why don't we come back here and take another look once we finish the school activity with Blue? Come on, let's go play. Yeah, rhyme time. It's time to rhyme. Let's go learn.
Hello, hello!
Peppo!
Hi, Mr. Salt and Mrs. Pepper.
Hello, Periwinkle. Are you enjoying playing school with Blue today?
It's great. Blue is showing me some of the things she does at school, so I'll know what it's like.
Like rhyme time?
What's rhyme time?
Rhyme time is a rhyming game Blue learned at school and plays with us at home.
Mrs. Pepper and I love rhymes.
Here. I'll show you what we mean. Rhyming words are words that have the same sound at the end, like cat and hat.
They rhyme. How about that?
You just made a rhyme too, Periwinkle. You would be good at this game.
How do we play rhyme time?
Mr. Salt and I will show you some words, and you match the ones that rhyme.
Will you help me find the rhymes? You will? Perry Perfect. Let's play.
If we make enough rhymes, we can use them to make a poem.
Perry Poetry, I love it.
Just click on the refrigerator to begin. All right.
Mrs. Pepper will show you one word.
And Mr. Salt will show you some others. Then you choose the word that rhymes with mine.
Bow, bow.
Remember, you can use these numbers to change the level.
Très bien. Let us begin. Rat. What rhymes with that? Mat. Rat.
Hey, you found it.
Ten. What rhymes with that? Men. Ten.
Hey, you found it.
Hog. What rhymes with that? Dog, hog, that's a rhyme. Wig. What rhymes with that? Pig, wig.
Très bien!
Look, you've made four rhyming pairs.
Wow! We're a great rhyming team.
Ba-boo!
Hooray!
Yay!
You know what is a great way to use rhymes? Poetry!
Oh yes, that's a wonderful idea, Mr. Salt. Let's use the rhymes you found to write a poem.
Poetry sounds great to me.
Would you help us write a poem with our rhyming words?
Fantastic!
Hog. Pig. Wig. Rat.
Let's read our poem.
Excellent idea, Periwinkle. Click on the picture to hear our poem. Look up in the sky. What do you see? There are so many things that the clouds could be. Is that a dog or a hog. It's so hard to tell. But there's a pig and a wig. I can see them quite well. Can you see the big puffy rat on the white fluffy mat? Look fast before it changes into a man on a 10. Wow, that was terrific!
Excellent poem!
Yeah, you're a real poet.
And now we know it. Très bien!
Now we have something for you that can help you rhyme anytime. Click here to see.
Park. Which sound does my word start with? P. P is for park. Très bien!
Now let's find a rhyming word.
Bark. Which sound does my... B. B is for bark.
Great!
They rhyme. Magnifique. Glue. Which sound? GL. GL is for glue. Très bien.
Now let's find a rhyming word.
Two. Which sound does... TW. TW is for two.
Great!
They rhyme. Magnifique. Pig. Which sound does my word start? P. P is for pig.
Great! Now let's find a rhyming word.
Twig. Which sound does my word start with? TW. TW is for twig. Très bien. They rhyme. Magnifique. Jug. Which sound does my word start with? J. J is for jug.
You got it.
Now let's find a rhyming word.
Slug. Which sound does my word start with? SL. SL is for slug.
Great!
They rhyme. Magnifique. Look! You've made four rhyming pairs.
Wow! We're a great rhyming team.
Ba-boo!
Hooray!
Yay!
You know what is a great way to use rhymes? Poetry!
Oh yes, that's a wonderful idea, Mr. Salt.
Can we write another poem with our rhymes?
Bow, bow, bow.
Of course. Will you help us? Très bien.
Move our words into the blank spaces in our poem.
Bark. Twig.
Let's read our poem.
Cover your eyes and close them too. Blue has a big surprise for you. Could it be a jug or maybe a slug? Do you think it's a twig or a lovely old pig? I hope it's a bark or a big shiny park. What is it? What is it? A great big glue? No, not at all. It is a two. Oh, that was terrific.
Excellent poem.
Yeah, you're a real poet.
And now we know it. Très bien.
Now we have something for you that can help you rhyme anytime. Click here to see your project page.
Green. Where is the rhyme? Queen, green, that's a rhyme. Stick, where is the rhyme? Chick, stick, that's a rhyme. Hail, where is the rhyme? Whale, hail.
You found the rhyme.
Crane, where is the rhyme? Drain, crane, that's a rhyme. Look, you've made four rhyming pairs.
Wow, we're a great rhyming team.
Ba-boo!
Hooray!
Yay!
You know what is a great way to use rhymes? Poetry!
Oh yes, that's a wonderful idea, Mr. Salt.
Can we write another poem with our rhymes?
Bow, bow, bow.
Of course. Crane. Green. Queen.
Let's read our poem.
Rhyme time is a time that I love. Don't you see? I can rhyme drain with crane. Most naturally, chick rhymed with stick. Sounds poetic to me. Whale, hail, and green. Queen, fill me with glee. Won't you come and play rhyme time with me?
Yay!
Oh, that was terrific!
Excellent poem!
Yeah, you're a real poet.
And now we know it. Très bien!
Now we have some...
This project looks terrific. There's a rhyming game to play around the house. I bet you'll be good at that. Click on your print button to print the project.
What a magnifique project!
Yeah!
We can try more rhyming later.
Spoon rhymes with moon.
Fork rhymes with stork.
Whisk rhymes with disc.
Time to go? Au revoir!
Come back soon!
Yeah, you can keep your project pages here and... Yeah, I wonder what school activity that's the cubby that Blue made for me. Can you? Yeah, Blue, that cubby's yours. And when I go to school, I'm gonna have my own cubby too. Telling time with Tickety. Interesting. Let's try it.
Hi, Blue. Hi, Periwinkle.
Hi, Tickety. Are you playing hide and seek with Joe?
Yeah, but I always have time for telling time.
Blue, is this something I will get to do in school too?
I like to practice telling time.
Can I try too?
Would you like to help me and Periwinkle practice telling time? Great! All you have to do is move my arms to the right numbers. That way, we can show the times of the day Blue does different things.
This will be great!
Click on me if it's time to learn about telling time.
I can't wait to learn about telling time. Click on Tickety if you're ready.
Blue. Green. Orange. Pink. Here comes the sun. The sun comes up early in the morning. All clocks have a long hand and a short hand, just like me. My short hand points at the hour. When it's 6 o'clock, my short hand points at the 6. When it's 9 o'clock, my short hand points at the 9. And when it's 12 o'clock, it points at the 12, and my long hand does too. My long hand points straight up like this at the beginning of every hour. Let's practice telling time. Let's point to Blue's dinner time. Will you set my short hand to the right time? Yep, 5 o'clock is Blue's dinner time. Let's try another one. Move my short hand to the time when Blue wakes up. Yeah! Blue gets up at 8 o'clock in the morning. Okay, when is snack time at Blue's house? Try again. Good job! 3 o'clock is Blue's snack time. Okay, will you move my short hand to the time when Blue has breakfast? You got it! Breakfast time at Blue's house is 9 o'clock. Okay, help me point at the time when Blue does art at her art table. Yes! Art time for Blue is 11 o'clock. Congratulations! You got 5 in a row! You're really good at this time-telling stuff. Speaking of telling time, I think it's time to give you a special time-telling project. Click right here to see your project page. All clocks have a long hand and a short hand. Just like me. I use my shorthand to show what the hour is, like this. See? Now it's 9 o'clock. And my long hand is pointing straight up like this. If my long hand is pointing up, the hour has just started. Every time a minute goes by, I move my long hand just a little bit, like this. When 30 minutes have gone by, my long hand is pointing down like this. Now it's 9:30. You know why? Because my long hand has counted 30 minutes since 9 o'clock. 9. 30. See? The hour's half over. It takes me a whole hour to move my long hand all the way around. But once I've counted 60 minutes, you can tell that a whole hour has gone by. See? It's 10 o'clock. My short hand is pointing to the 10. And my long hand is pointing straight up again. If my long hand is pointing up, the hour has just started. And if it's pointing down, the hour is half over. Why don't we practice telling time? Blue is going to visit Periwinkle at his fort at 2:30. What does 2:30 look like? Let's start with my shorthand. Where does my shorthand point when it's 2:30? Great! Now, will you remind me? Yes, that's the the right time. Okay. Will you set the clock to Blue's bedtime? Blue goes to bed at 7 o'clock. Great! Good time telling. Let's try another one. At 5:30, Blue likes to sing songs with Joe. Let's show what 5:30 looks like. Let's start with my shorthand. Where does my shorthand point when it's 5:30? Oops! Oops! Great! You did it! You can tell time. Now try this. Will you set the time to 4 o'clock? That's when Blue plays on the computer. Great! Hey, you're right on time! Let's try another one. At 12:30, Blue listens to music. Try setting the time to 12:30. Great! Now... Good time telling! Congratulations! You got 5 in a row! You're really good at this time telling stuff. Speaking of telling time, all clocks have a long hand and a short hand, just like me. I use my short hand to show what the hour is, like this. See? Now it's 7 o'clock. And my long hand is pointing straight up like this. If my long hand is pointing up, the hour has just started. I move my long hand as the hour goes by. After 15 minutes, my long hand is here, pointing to the 3. That's why it's 7:15, because my short hand is pointing to the 7. And my long hand shows that 15 minutes have passed. Every time a minute goes by, I move my long hand just a little bit. By the time 30 minutes have gone by, my long hand is pointing down like this. Now it's 7:30, because 30 minutes have gone by since 7 o'clock. 7. 30. See? The hour's half over. But we keep counting the minutes as they go by. When 45 minutes have gone by, my long hand is pointing like this. Now it's 7:45. Because my short hand is pointing to the 7. And my long hand shows that 45 minutes have passed. See? 7. 45. It takes me a whole hour to move my long hand all the way around, back to the top. Once I've counted 60 minutes, a whole hour has gone by. See? It must be 8 o'clock. My short hand is pointing to the 8. And my long hand is pointing straight up again. My short hand tells you what the hour is. And my long hand tells you how many minutes have passed since the hour started. Why don't we practice telling time? Blue is going to call Periwinkle on the phone at 11:15. Let's see what 11:15 looks like. Let's start with... Great! Yes, that's the right time. Okay. Blue likes to brush her teeth at 9:30. Let's show what 9:30 looks like. Great! You did it! You can tell time. Okay. Try setting the time to 10 o'clock, when Blue likes to play with her blocks. Great! Now, will you remind me where my long hand points when it's 10 o'clock? Good time telling. Now try this. At 5:45, Blue picks out a book for story time. Set the time to 5:45. Great! Hey, you're right on time! Okay. At 8:30, Blue gets dressed. Let's move my hands to 8:30. Great! Try again. Hey, you're right on time! Congratulations! You got 5 in a row! You're really good at this time-telling stuff.
I like telling time. I hope...
Okay, come back later and we can play some more.
Good idea, Tickety. See you soon. Yeah, I wonder what's... Wow, school must really be your thing. You've... Wow, school must really...
Bow-bow-bow-bow.
Yeah, I wonder what school activity we should play. The book about us.
Bow-bow-bow.
This sounds great. To school we go.
Bow-bow.
Hi, Blue. Hi, Periwinkle. Hi, Marky Marker. Blue is teaching me all about the things she does at school, like math, reading, and science.
Bow, bow.
Yeah, Blue and I work together on our projects for her to teach school all the time.
Bow, bow, bow.
What kinds of art projects?
Bow, 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 bow.
Yes, books. I just love helping Blue make books.
Bow, 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 bow.
Good idea, Blue. We can make a book right now. Let's make a book about us.
That's a great idea.
Then I can bring it to school and show it to all my new friends so they can learn all about me.
You help make a book about us. We need some pages all about you. Great. Click on me to get started.
Look. There are all kinds of stickers you can use to decorate our book.
Use these to see more stickers. You can always use your eraser or this button here. If you want to start your page over, you can print your page whenever you want. When you've finished all your pages and printed them out, you can put them together to make a real book about you and Periwinkle and Blue. But first things first. Let's start on the first page. It will be all about you. Let's put your name on it, and you can decorate it however you want. Choose how you want your name to look using these. This page is all about your home and family. Here you can add a picture of where you live. Which one of these reminds you of home? On this page, let's put some of your favorite snacks. Imagine that it's my birthday page, my home and family page. My birthday page. My snacks page. On this page, let's put some animals that you like. You're a really good bookmaker. Now I have a cool project for you. Page about you. How's it going? Yeah, I can't wait to do art projects like this when I go to school. What should we do now?
What are you gonna put in your book about us?
You can still add things and make changes to your page. How's it going?
Add just a little bit of blue to your red, and it makes a nice red-violet color called magenta.
One,
two,
three!
School is great. I can't wait to find out the other things I'm gonna do there.
Okay, you can come back later and add to your book about us.
Good idea. See you later, Marky.
Bye.
Yeah. Wow, school must really be your thing. You. Math collections. Wow, great. Let's try it.
Bye-bye.
Hi, Blue. Hi, Periwinkle.
Hi, what are you doing?
We drew a chart in the sand, just like the charts Blue uses in school to learn math.
What do you use a chart for?
Bye-bye.
Yeah, charts are great for categories and numbers.
And counting how many types of things you have in a collection.
Really? I have a magic collection. Could we use a chart to count the things in my magic collection?
We could play with the chart, just like Blue does at school.
All right, this is my magic bag, where I keep all my collections. I have shells and magic rings, toy cars, and all kinds of things.
That's great, Periwinkle. We can count your collections by using the sand table chart.
Will you help us put my collections on the chart? You will? Oh, good. We'll play at the level you chose earlier. But if you think it's too easy or too hard, you can click on the numbers in the corner and pick a new level.
Let's play. Click on the chart when you're ready to start. This shape is a rectangle.
This is a circle.
Flower. F-L-O-W-E-R. One,
two,
three,
four,
five,
six,
seven.
Let's play with my shell collection.
Put all of the shells with brown stripes here on the chart. Great, that's all of them. How many shells with brown stripes are there? Count them and use the number rocks under the sand table to show how many there are.
3, 4.
Okay, now let's move the shells with orange stripes to the other row of our chart. Great, that's all
3.
So we have
4
shells with brown stripes and
3
shells with orange stripes. How many shells are there all together?
7.
Good adding.
Let's do another one.
Okay.
This time, let's play with my toy building collection.
Put all of the yellow buildings here on the chart. Great. That's all
3.
Okay, now let's move the red buildings to the other row of our chart. Great, that's all of them. How many?
5.
So we have
3
yellow buildings and
5
red buildings. How many toy buildings are there all together?
8.
Good adding.
Let's do another one.
Okay.
This time, let's play with my collection of magic rings.
Put all of the magenta magic rings here on the chart. Great. That's all of
3.
Okay. Great, that's
3.
So we have
6.
Good adding.
Let's do another one.
Okay.
This time, let's play with my rock collection.
Put all of the green rocks here on the chart. Great, that's all of them.
3.
Great, that's all
2.
So we have
3
green rocks and
2
black rocks. How many rocks are there all together?
5.
Good adding.
Thank you for your help.
Yeah, you're a real math whiz.
Here's a project page for you so you can keep practicing math.
Click here if you want to see it. These are all of my collections. What should we play with first?
Let's start by putting all of the toy airplanes here on the chart. Great, that's all of them.
3.
Okay, now let's move the toy trucks to the other row of our chart. We want to... Great, that's all of them. How many toy trucks are there? Count them and use the number rocks under the sand table to show how many there are.
10.
So how many toy airplanes and toy trucks does Periwinkle have all together?
13.
Good adding.
Let's do another one.
Okay, this time, let's start by putting all of the magic rings here on the chart. Let's put the... Great.
9.
Okay, now let's move the keys to the other row of our chart. Great.
That's three.
So how many?
12.
Good adding.
Let's do another one.
Okay, this time, let's start by putting all of the toy airplanes here on the chart. Great, that's all of them. How many toy airplanes are there? Count them and use the number rocks under the sand table to show how many there are.
4.
Okay, now let's move the shells to the other row of our chart. Great, that's all of them.
4.
So how many toy airplanes?
8.
Good adding.
Let's do another one.
Okay, this time, let's start by putting all of the rocks here on the chart. Great, that's all of them. How many?
2.
Okay, now let's move the toy trucks to the other row of our chart. Let's put the... Great, that's
8.
So how many?
10.
Good adding.
Thank you for your help.
Yeah, you're a real math whiz.
Here's a project page for you so you can keep practicing math. Click here if you want to see it. These are all of my collections. What should we play with first?
Let's start by putting all of the rocks here on the chart. Great, that's all of them.
6. Thanks, Blue. It's a pretty great rock collection. You know what? Let's share them. I could give you 2. Then you'd have a collection all your own. Great idea, Periwinkle.
Let's count out 2.
Okay. Will you help us move 2 of these from the top row of the chart down to this row?
Great, that's all of them. How many rocks?
2.
So if I get
4.
You got it.
Let's do another one.
Okay, this time, let's start by putting all of the magic rings here on the chart. Great,
that's 9. Thanks, Blue. It's a pretty great collection of magic rings. You know what? Let's share them. I could give you 7. Then you'd have a collection all your own. Great idea, Periwinkle.
Let's count out 7.
Okay, will you help us move 7 of these from the top row of the chart down to this row?
Great, that's all
7.
2. You got it.
Let's do another one.
Okay, this time, let's start by putting all of the toy buildings here on the chart. Great. That's all five.
Thanks, Blue. It's a pretty great toy building collection. You know what? Let's share them. I could give you three. Then you'd have a collection all your own.
Great idea, Periwinkle.
Let's count out three.
Okay. Will you help us move three of these from the top row of the chart down to this row?
Great. That's all
three. Two.
You got it. Let's do another one.
Okay, this time, let's start by putting all of the magic rings here on the chart. Great, that's all of five.
Thanks, Blue. It's a pretty great collection of magic rings. You know what? Let's share them. I could give you three. Then you'd have a collection all your own.
Great idea, Periwinkle.
Let's count out three.
Okay. Will you help us move three of these from the top row of the chart down to this row?
Great. That's all
three.
So if I gave
two,
you got it.
Thank you for your help.
Yeah, you're a real math whiz.
Here's a project page for you so you can keep practicing math. Click here if you want to see it.
That was great.
Wow. You can practice more on the chart later.
I'd like that. Wow. What should we do now?
Okay, Blue. See you soon.
Bye. Yeah, I wonder what school activity we should play. They all sound pretty neat. What game would you like to try? Wow, school must really be your thing. You've got 12 project pages. There are more school time activities to do together. So let's keep playing. Yeah, I wonder what school activity we should play. Super science. It's science time. This sounds super. Welcome to my fort, Blue. I brought some of my favorite things to my fort. Here's my aquarium, my plants, and my space poster. We can play school in my fort. Yeah, my space poster is very perfect to learn about space. Will you help me learn about space with Blue Super Science Game? Great, we'll play the game at the level you chose before. If it's too easy or too hard, remember, you can click on the numbers in the corner and pick a new level. Click on the poster to start our game.
Hi there. Glad you've joined us. Ready to learn all about space? I thought you might like that. There are lots of stellar facts to learn about here. Just click on one of us to hear for yourself. Or click here if you'd like to play the Who Is It game. Remember, you can use these numbers to change your level. Let's explore the solar system. The Sun. Hi there, I'm the sun. Click on these buttons to learn more enlightening stuff about me. My name has just three letters, S-U-N, sun. I'm as yellow as a baby chick, but don't look at me, I'm so bright I could hurt your eyes. I'm as yellow as a baby chick, but don't look at me, I'm so bright I could hurt your eyes. I may look like a flat, shiny plate up in the sky, but I'm really a big, spinning ball of fire.
Mercury. Hi, I'm Mercury. Want to learn more about me? Good. Click on these buttons to hear some super stuff about me. My name is spelled M-E-R-C-U-R-Y. Mercury. I'm gray and look a lot like the moon when you see me in pictures. I'm covered with holes and craters, kind of like the moon. I'm gray and look a lot like the moon when you...
Venus!
Hello there, I'm Venus. Click on these buttons to learn about me. My name is spelled V-E-N-U-S, Venus. I'm the brightest planet. In fact, you've probably seen me in the night sky and thought I was a star. I shine bright in the night sky because I'm wrapped in a blanket of yellowy clouds.
Earth! Hey there, I'm the planet Earth. I'm the planet where you live. But I bet there are some things you don't know about me. Click on these buttons to learn some stuff about me. Will you spell my name with me? It's E-A-R-T-H. Earth. From space, I look like a shiny blue and white marble. It's my oceans that make me look so blue. I'm the only planet with liquid water on me. In fact, most of the Earth is covered by water. That means there's more water than land on me.
The moon! Hi there. I've seen you before. I'm the moon. Want to learn more about me? Click on these. I spell my name M-O-O-N. Moon. Sometimes the air on Earth makes me look different colors, but I'm really quite gray. Ever heard the expression man in the moon? Some people think they can see a face on me. Do you?
Jupiter.
Mars. Howdy, I'm Mars. You can learn about me by clicking on these buttons. I'm known as the Red Planet because I'm covered with red dirt. Mars is spelled with just four letters. M-A-R-S. Mars. Mars is spelled with just four letters. M-A-R-S. Mars. I'm round like all the other planets. But those big bumps on me are some of the tallest volcanoes in the solar system.
Jupiter. Hey there, my name is Jupiter. You can learn about me by clicking on these buttons. Want to spell Jupiter? It's J-U-P-I-T-E-R. Jupiter.
I look a little like someone stepped on me.
I'm round, but a bit flat on top, and fat around the middle. My clouds come in lots of different colors, and they make stripes that go all around me.
Saturn, I'm Saturn. Nice to meet you. Would you like to learn about me? Great! Just click S-A-T-U-R-N. That's how you spell my name, Saturn.
I'm famous for my icy rings. They're the prettiest set in the solar system.
I don't have stripes like Jupiter, but my golden color makes me one of a kind, and so do my great rings.
Uranus.
Hi, my name is Uranus. Nice to meet you. Click on these buttons to learn some stuff about me. My name is spelled U-R-A-N-U-S. Uranus. I bet you don't know anyone else named that. I'm different from the other planets. I spin on my side. I'm blue, just like Neptune. Uranus.
Neptune. Hi, I'm Neptune. Click on one of these to learn more about me. Neptune is a long name. N-E-P-T-U-N-E. Neptune. I'm almost a twin to Uranus, just a little smaller, and I'm not tipped over on my side like Uranus is. I'm blue, just like Uranus.
Pluto, hi there. I'm Pluto. Thanks for coming way out here to meet me. Click on one of these to learn more about me. Do you want to learn how to spell Pluto? It's P-L-U-T-O. Pluto. Not only am I the farthest planet from the sun, I'm also the very smallest. Not only am I the farthest planet from the sun, I'm also the very smallest. I'm so small and so far away that I look pretty dim in the night sky. You can only find me with a big telescope.
Wow!
Hi there. Glad you've joined. Let's play the Who Is It game. Here's how it works. I'm going to describe my planet, friends, and you figure out who it is. Who is almost a twin to Uranus? Try that one again.
Wow, nice job. I'm Neptune. I'm almost a twin to Uranus, just a little smaller, and I'm not tipped over on my side like Uranus is.
Who is actually gray, although he may look different colors to you on Earth? Try that one again.
I'm the brightest planet, Venus. Try again.
That's right, the moon.
Sometimes the air on Earth makes me look different colors, but I'm really quite gray.
Who has the tallest volcanoes in the solar system?
Great job. I'm Mars. I'm round like all the other planets. But those big bumps on me are some of the tallest volcanoes in the solar system.
Who is so small and so far away that he can only be seen with a big telescope?
You got it! I'm Pluto. I'm so small and so far away that I look pretty dim in the night sky. You can only find me with a big telescope.
Where is the sun? It looks like you're pretty bright as well. Good job. I'm the sun.
My name has just three letters. S-U-N, sun.
Peri near and peri far. You're a super space star. Thanks for helping me with the planets. You really know a lot about space.
You sure do. In fact, I'd like to give you a project page for being such a stellar scientist. Click here to see what you've earned.
This looks like the peri-perfect project for someone who knows so much about space. Here are some planet pictures you can use to make a space mobile. Cool! Click on your print button to print the project.
Wow!
Yeah, space sounds great, and you know all about it. Do you want to learn more about space? Click on the poster to play some more.
The sun. I'm so big, you could put almost 1,000 Jupiters inside me. And Jupiter's the biggest planet here. I'm made entirely of hot gas. You couldn't go for a walk on me. I give the Earth light and heat. Without me, it would be really dark and cold.
Mercury.
Hi. I'm the second smallest planet. It would take 17 of me to equal the size of your planet Earth. I'm the closest planet to the sun. I'm named after someone who is famous for his speed. None of the other planets can make it around the sun as fast as I can.
Venus!
Hello there! I'm Venus. I may not be the largest planet, but I am the largest planet without any moons. I've got things a little backwards, it seems. I spin backwards compared to the planets around me. Some people say that planet Earth and I are twins, because we're almost exactly the same size.
Earth! Hey there! I'm the planet Earth! I'm the planet where you live! But I bet there are some things you don't know about me. Click on these buttons to learn some stuff about me. I'm the third planet out from the sun. Mercury and Venus are both closer to the sun than I am. I am the only planet that has a moon that people have walked on. I'm the only planet with water you can splash in, make snowmen with, and enjoy as fluffy clouds.
The moon!
Hi there. I've seen you before. I'm the moon. Want to learn more about me? Click on these. A lot of planets have a whole lot of moons, but the Earth has just one. Me! It takes me 1 month to travel all the way around the Earth.
Mars!
Howdy, I'm Mars. You can learn about me by clicking on these buttons. I'm about half as wide as the planet Earth. My day lasts almost exactly as long as a day on Earth. Actually, it's just a few minutes longer.
I have two small moons that circle all the way around me, just like your moon circles around Earth.
Hey there, my name is Jupiter. You can learn about me by clicking on these buttons.
I'm the largest planet.
A day on Earth lasts 24 hours, but I have the shortest day of all the planets in the solar system, only 10 hours. I'm the fifth planet out from the sun, the first one that isn't hard and rocky.
Saturn.
I'm Saturn.
Nice to meet you.
I'm the fluffiest planet. I'm light and airy like a cloud, not rocky and hard like a lot of planets are. If you put me in an enormous lake, I would float. I'm the sixth planet away from the sun, between Jupiter and Uranus. I'm the second largest planet, after Jupiter, of course.
Uranus.
Hi, my name is Uranus. Nice to meet you. Click on these buttons to learn some stuff about me. I'm the third largest planet. I'm the seventh planet from the sun. Brr, it's pretty cold out here. Saturn isn't the only planet with rings. Neptune and I have got some too.
Neptune.
Hi, I'm Neptune. Click on one of these to learn more about me. I'm big, but I'm not slow. It takes me just 16 hours to spin around once. Little Earth takes 24 hours. Usually, I'm between Uranus and Pluto. Every once in a while, I switch places with Pluto. That means that sometimes I'm the farthest planet from the sun.
Pluto, hi there. I'm Pluto. I'm pretty small for a planet. I'm even smaller than the Earth's moon. I have one moon of my own that's about half the size of me. It's so cold out here, so far away from the sun, I'm actually made of icy rock. Cool, huh?
Space amazing? Thanks for playing with us. What do you want to play now?
Hi there. Glad you've joined us. Let's play the Who Is It game. Here's how it works.
I'm going to describe my planet, friends, and you figure out who it is. Who is the second smallest planet in the solar system? Try that one again.
I'm Neptune. Sometimes I'm farther away from the sun than Pluto. Try again.
Click me. I'm Mercury. Yes, it's me, Mercury. I'm the second smallest planet. It would take 17 of me to equal the size of your planet Earth.
Who up here is even smaller than Earth's moon? Who up here is even smaller than Earth's moon?
Here I am, Pluto. I'm pretty small for a planet. I'm even smaller than the Earth's moon.
Who gives the Earth light and heat? Here I am, the sun. I give the Earth light and heat. Without me, it would be really dark and cold. Who has rings around her, just like Saturn, Jupiter, and Neptune? Try that one again.
I'm Saturn, the second largest planet. Try again.
You found me, Uranus. Saturn isn't the only planet with rings. Neptune and I have got some too.
Who is the second largest planet?
Yes! It's me, Saturn! I'm the second largest planet. After Jupiter, of course.
Very far. You're a super space star. Thanks for helping me with the planets. You really know a lot about space.
You sure do. In fact, I'd like to give you a project page for being such a stellar scientist. Click here to see what you've earned. I'm the sun. Click on these buttons to learn more enlightening stuff about me. From where you are, I look about the same size as the moon, but I'm actually much larger. I'm actually a star, like the ones you see in the sky at night, but I'm much closer to you than the other stars, so I look much bigger. I'm the center of the solar system. All of the other planets, including Earth, travel around me, and I give them light and heat.
Mercury. Hi. I'm Mercury. Want to learn more about me? Good. Click on these buttons to hear some super stuff about me. It doesn't take me long to travel around the sun. My year only lasts 88 days. That's the shortest year of all the planets. I'm so close to the sun, it's hard for people on Earth to see me because the sun is so bright. My temperature range is pretty extreme. It can be freezing cold at night and boiling hot at noon.
The sun.
Hello there, I'm Venus. Click on these buttons to learn about me. My surface temperature is the hottest of all the planets, and I'm not even the closest planet to the sun. I'm the second planet out from the sun, just a little bit closer to it than the Earth is. My path around the sun is almost a perfect circle.
the planet where you live. But I bet there are some things you don't know about me. Click on these buttons to learn some stuff about me. I'm the densest planet of them all. If you were to put all the planets in an enormous swimming pool, I would sink the fastest. There are 365 days in my year and 24 hours in my day. Thanks to oxygen in my atmosphere and water on my surface, I'm the only planet people can live on.
The moon!
Hi there. I've seen you before. I'm the moon. Want to learn more about me? Click on these. I affect the Earth's oceans. Without me, there wouldn't be any tides. I'm the only other place in space, besides the Earth, that people have walked on. If I'm in just the right spot in the sky, I can completely cover the sun. That's called an eclipse.
Mars!
Howdy, I'm Mars.
You can learn about me by clicking on these buttons. A year is a long time, especially for me. It takes me almost twice as long to get around the sun as it takes Earth. The largest volcano in the entire solar system is on me. My weather changes very quickly.
Jupiter. Hey there. My name is Jupiter. You can learn about me by clicking on these buttons.
There are four planets made of gas and liquid. Me, Saturn, Uranus, and Neptune. And I'm the biggest of them all. Not only am I the largest planet in the solar system, one of my many moons is the largest moon in the solar system. I have a hurricane-like storm on me called the Great Red Spot. I have a hurricane-like storm.
I'm Saturn. Nice to meet you. Would you like to learn about me? Great! Just click on these buttons to hear some cool facts. I'm made of gas and liquid, just like Jupiter, Uranus, and Neptune. I'm so far out from the sun, my rings are frozen. I'm so far out from the sun, it takes me almost 30 years to get around the sun just one time. Saturn.
Hi, my name is Uranus. Nice to meet you. Click on these buttons to learn some stuff about me. I'm so big, you could line up four planets the size of Earth across my middle. I spin backwards, just like Venus.
Mm-hmm.
have so many thick clouds around me that when people look at me, that's all they can see.
Neptune! Hi. I'm Neptune. Click on one of these. I'm the fourth largest planet. Jupiter, Saturn, and Uranus are all bigger than I am. I'm 30 times farther away from the Sun than the Earth is. I'm so far away from the Sun, it takes 4 hours for sunlight to reach me. I'm so far away from the Sun.
The Sun.
Hi there, I'm...
It's lonely out here. I'm the only planet that hasn't been visited by a spacecraft from the Earth.
I'm the coolest planet. Seriously, my temperatures can reach 380 degrees below zero. It takes me 249 Earth years to make it around the Sun once.
Let's play the Who Is It game. Here's how it works. I'm going to describe my planet, friends, and you figure out who it is. If positioned just right, someone in space can make an eclipse of the Sun. Do you know who it is?
Yes, that's me, the Moon. If I'm in just the right spot in the sky, I can completely cover the Sun. That's called an eclipse.
Find the fourth largest planet. Find the fourth largest planet. Try that one again.
Good job. I'm Neptune. I'm the fourth largest planet. Jupiter, Saturn, and Uranus are all bigger than I am.
Who is the coldest planet?
Yes, it's me, Pluto. I'm the coolest planet. Seriously. My temperatures can reach 380 degrees below zero.
Who is known for his frozen rings?
Good going! I'm Saturn. I'm so far out from the Sun, my rings are frozen.
Who has such thick clouds around her that when you look at her, that's all you can see.
You got it. Good job. I'm Uranus. I have so many thick clouds around me that when people look at me, that's all they can see.
Peri near and peri far. You're a super space star. Helping me with the planets. You really know a lot about space.
You sure do. In fact, I'd like to give you a project page for being such a stellar scientist. Click here to see what you've earned.
Wow! Isn't space amazing?
Good job. Now I'm going to find a really hard hiding place. See if you can find me.
Let's go play something else.
Bow, bow, bow.
Let's go.
Bow, 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 bow.
Yeah, I wonder what school activity we should play. They all sound pretty. Wow, school must really be your thing. You've got 15 project pages. We've tried a little bit of everything. Do you want to print one of your project pages now? Or we can get back to playing school with Blue.
Bow, 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 bow.
Wow, school must...
Bow, 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 bow.
idea. I wonder what school activity we should play. They all sound pretty neat. What game would you like to try?
That wraps up Blue's Clues, Blue's Kindergarten. I hope you enjoyed this gameplay. If you did, please give this video a thumbs up, leave a comment down below sharing your thoughts, and subscribe for more nostalgic gaming. Remember to check out the playlist in the description box for more Blue's Clues videos if you want to see more. You are all special and loved. You are never alone, and you're always welcome to hang out. Until the next video, God bless. I'll see you all later. Bye-bye, everyone.
What school activity sounds good to you? You can change any of the stuff here that you want, and you can change the screen about the things you like too. Do you want to change some? I feel like I'm ready for school now, Joe.
You are? That's great.
Yeah, playing school showed me what real school is gonna be like. And now I can't wait to go.
That's great, Periwinkle. Thank you so much for helping Blue and Periwinkle play school. Come back and play with us again soon.